the backstory to my God. So, there's Eternals. Eternals is a group of godlike creatures, and the first two Eternals were Uranus and Cronus. Cronus was, they had civil war because they were brothers, and so one wanted to take over the world, the other one wanted to just stay in his planet and chill. So, but they ended up having civil war, and Uranus ended up dying and getting killed by Cronus. Cronus had a kid named Mentor. Mentor ended up having a son named Thanos. So, that's how Thanos came to be. Thanos in the Bible. So, Thanos, of course, is a godlike figure to me. The death of Gamora pretty much symbolizes Jesus, pretty much, because Thanos sacrifices Gamora to, as like a Jesus, for his purpose for the whole world is to wipe out and cleanse it, like God. So, and then, Thanos leaves, when Gamora dies, he pretty much fulfills his purpose. That's why they're in an earthquake, that's when he wipes out the whole half of the world. And now Thanos is in this peaceful place, like in the movie. The creator. Stanley is Captain America. He's been freezing himself for the last million years, and each time he's been kind of getting a little dumb. So he's in Greek mythology, Japanese mythology, and mythology and Norse mythology. So they've been, you know, slowly telling different stories that are kind of similar that you can really read about. Next slide. Future grounding in this quiet place, chilling, and looking at the sunrise. He will eventually die because his grandfather will kill him. And that's how we will die, because he will kill because Thanos is the god of this galaxy, the god of the universe, it's Cronus. So Cronus will eventually kill Thanos.
More thoughts.
This is my theory, it's called the first theory of Thanos. So this is my god. Now we're gonna see fiction, there's the realistic stuff, and there's fake stuff. So, when they hear about a god, they can pretty much see it as a Thanos-looking god figure. Because they're like, they first hear about God, and they're like, how could this guy be created the whole world, created everything, he could snap his fingers and literally kill us. That's what they pretty much say God, Jesus, could do, right? So, how can we judge them for not believing in this God, right? But give yourself a pat on the back because you obviously believe in something great. Because we all know that God sent his son Jesus.